Riding the wave of China's meteoric economic rise in the last 40 years, Hong Kong has been able to move from cotton spinning and manufacturing into financial and commercial services, giving companies around the world a place to do their banking, borrow money, and sell shares. Hong Kong has a lot to offer. Low taxes, the fact that money could move in and out of it easily, a stable business environment, and a legal system based on that of the UK. It attracted companies from all over the world.
What made Hong Kong so unique is really its economic fundamentals remain firmly vested.
This status as a global financial center and the cash that comes with it has made Hong Kong what it is today, a thriving, buzzy metropolis. But with the protests of the last year, which brought the city to a standstill, and the imposition of the new security law, Hong Kong's future as a global financial center is in doubt.
It will be Beijing that will control the future of Hong Kong, for good and for bad. And so I think that's one of the challenges when we talk about, will Hong Kong remain an international financial center?
But there are plenty of cities in the region who'd be keen to take its place. Enter stage right, Singapore. The Lion City seems an obvious contender. It's got a stable government and offers many of the same benefits that Hong Kong does. Low taxes, an easy business environment, and lower rent. But the size of its financial system is far smaller than Hong Kong's. Its stock market, for instance, is about a seventh of the size of Hong Kong's. Then you've got Tokyo, a major financial center already, but Japan has some hurdles, including high taxes and a language barrier. Meanwhile, Sydney is pouring billions into its own version of Silicon Valley, calling that area Tech Central. High taxes and its geographic remoteness, though, are a challenge to it becoming a financial hub. And that's not to mention the other contenders, such as Bangkok, Taiwan, Seoul, or even Chinese cities such as Shanghai and Shenzhen. It won't be easy, though, to replace Hong Kong.
The flow of money that comes in and out of Hong Kong on a daily basis, that goes into mainland China and comes out, is very hard to replicate.
So, as long as the money is flowing, the bright lights of Hong Kong will stay on. Katie Silver, BBC News.